Okay, page 80. Let's look at page 80. We're going to write our name at the top. And this is helping verbs and past participles. Say that last word again, participles. A helping verb such as, I want you to underline these, have, has, or had, comes before the main regular verb and tells more about what happened in the past. Helping verbs must agree with the subject of the sentence. Use these helping verbs with past participles. Okay? The past participle of a regular verb is the past tense form. So it's add the ed, circle that, to the end of the regular verb. If the verb ends in e, you drop the e before adding ed. Past participle forms use helping verbs to show past actions. So, they have watched that movie 3 times. Okay, they have watched that movie 3 times. So our helping verb is have. You can see we added our ed, so there's where it comes in at. Right? She has liked the movie as well. Okay? There's our helping verb, has, right there. It says, write the past participle of the verb in parentheses. So already I know this one's going to have an ed, right? Underline the helping verb. So in this first one, Jane's aunt has, there's my helping verb, performed. Stunts for movies. Okay, I underlined my helping verb and I wrote my past participle of the verb on the line. Okay, let's look at 5 through 8. Underline the past participle in each sentence. Write the appropriate helping verb. So it's the opposite of this. I blank enjoyed many comedy movies. Do I put I has enjoyed? No, that doesn't sound right. I have enjoyed? That sounds right. So I'm going to write the word have. That doesn't mean these are all going to be have. You need to decide if it's going to be have, has, or had. Say the sentence out loud to yourself so you know which one makes sense. I have enjoyed many comedy movies. Underline the past participle in each sentence. Well, it's enjoyed. It's right next to my helping verb. Okay? If you need to, review this section again. Rewind the video. If you get stuck, come and ask me. It's your turn.